Hey guys, what's up? Welcome back to my channel and welcome back to another Sims 4 speed build. Today is another episode of Curb Appeal, the series on my channel where I attempt to recreate photographs of houses in The Sims 4. So today's episode is a very exciting one because we are doing another build that is kind of on the hype train of the new Sims 4 Eco Lifestyle Expansion Pack. Now, that pack has not yet been released, but we have seen the trailer and we have, you know, seen the announcement and stuff. So I don't really know what the pack is going to be like yet, and we haven't really seen much of it, so I don't really have any, you know, judgment or anything like that. I know a lot of people are skeptical about it, but I am trying to get inspired by building these kind of more eco-friendly homes lately. And yeah, I can't wait to get my hands on the pack to kind of learn more about it. So I have been doing a lot of kind of eco builds. Like I said, the one I did last was kind of like an eco village with like standalone homes and townhomes and a giant greenhouse and a communal space. So that was really cool. So if you are interested in seeing more like eco builds and stuff, definitely check that out. But today's build is a little bit different, so I am going to pop the photo of what I am recreating up on screen right here, right now, as per usual. So today's photo is really cool. I can't remember where I found it, probably on Pinterest, like where I find all of my photos, but it's basically like two container homes that are kind of next to each other with this cool like grated roof texture on top and then two large solar panels on top, which is kind of what in my mind makes this like an eco lifestyle themed build, because I do know that we are getting solar panels with the new expansion pack. So I thought that this would be a good time to kind of, you know, use these solar panels that we got in the debug menu of Get Famous to kind of replicate the whole like solar energy thing. And then obviously, you know, it's been built with container homes, so they've been repurposed into a home, so a little bit more eco-friendly and sustainable that way. But besides that, it is just a really cool looking build, and it was also in Oasis Springs, which I never build in Oasis Springs, you guys probably know that already, but I don't really know why I don't. Maybe because the lighting is a little bit weird in this world. I find that everything is just kind of orange and just not like the neutral color scheme I'm looking for, I guess. But with this photo, it was obviously in a desert climate, and I think that the colors really work for a kind of more natural desert, you know, rocky texture. So yeah, I had a lot of fun doing this one, and I did do this on stream as per usual. If you guys don't know, I know I say it in every video, but I do stream on Twitch every Tuesday at 4:30 Pacific Standard Time, 4:30 p.m. obviously. So you can go follow me there on Twitch. If you guys can't make it out to the streams, you guys can just watch the speed build anyway, so it's not a big deal, but it is always a really fun time to hang out with you guys, and I do implement like all of your guys' ideas during the stream. So if you guys want to see your ideas come to life, join the stream and you can have input. But besides that, also I do want to mention quickly that if you guys do want to submit photos for Curb Appeal and you want me to recreate a photo that you guys have in mind, I do have a Discord server and I'll link that down below. We have a channel in there called Curb Appeal Inspo, and you guys can submit photos there and then I can, you know, recreate them if I choose to. So yeah, I do get a lot of like requests for that, so I just wanted to let you guys know. But back to the build. The exterior and like the structure is pretty simple. It's just two little containers next to each other with a little grated roof. So for the container home kind of exterior, I use that kind of tin looking whatever sheet metal texture from the Strangerville game pack, and then for the roof I just used like the fencing tool and kind of drew out a little fence and then deleted the inside so we could make it kind of like see-through like that. And then, like I said, those solar panels are from the Get Famous debug menu, but if you are watching this after the Eco Lifestyle expansion pack already comes out, you can probably just go ahead and replace those with real solar panels because we will be getting those. But besides that, there isn't really much else to the build. I'm just doing the landscaping. The landscaping was definitely a really important part of this build, and I thought it was a little bit more fun to use kind of different landscaping, like plants and stuff that I don't usually use because I never build in Oasis Springs. So things like those little cactuses and the little like big succulent plants and these giant rocks and stuff, I felt really went well with the landscaping in this world. And all the other worlds that I build in, like, you know, Willow Creek, Brindleton Bay and stuff, you don't really put like cactuses or cacti in those worlds just because it doesn't really go. But because I was building in a desert setting, I finally got the opportunity to use them, and that was a suggestion by the chat. So thank you so much to everybody who helped with the landscaping there. And if you guys recognize it, I did put like a little cluster of cacti in the front lawn, and I put like four, and one was like the father cactus, one was the mother, and like two of them were the children. So yeah, it's kind of dumb, but I thought it was kind of cute. But anyways, we are now working on the interior. The exterior was super quick, and you know, that's what I like sometimes, doing like quick tiny homes so I can get onto the interior. So the interior is actually a really cool, cute concept. I wanted it to be kind of like a tiny home or a container home that's very, you know, it's eco-friendly, it's sustainable, and I wanted the interior to also be very modern. So I went with a kind of like monochromatic gray, black, white color scheme that felt like it was kind of one with nature. So the only kind of color that I brought into this build was through plants, and just overall kept it very gray and neutral to kind of make it feel like very, you know, you're submerged in nature kind of thing. I don't know if you're kind of catching my vibe here or not. Maybe you'll kind of see it at the end, but I do really love how it turns out and how I use kind of like the plants to draw in color here and there. Obviously, I have these massive big modern windows to add that modern vibe that I love, and also just to bring a lot of natural light into this home, especially when you're going for a really neutral gray color scheme. It can get really kind of drab and dreary really quickly if you just rely on interior lighting, so you definitely should add in those big modern windows so that you can kind of see more colors and see more landscaping when you're looking out from the inside. So I do love that touch. Now, the chat in my stream did choose this bed here, the one from Vintage Glamour. It's a fan favorite, you guys. Everybody loves this bed. I personally love it. And then we did decide to use the Moschino stuff pack end tables there with our favorite City Living fluffy rug. I have like a weird obsession with that rug. It's just like the best rug in game. They need to make more of them in various sizes, shapes, colors, everything that, you know, it needs to happen. I like joked about how I basically purchased the City Living pack just for that rug, like no joke. And this was back when I only had base game and like I needed to buy a new pack. And I'm like, well, obviously I'm gonna buy City Living because I want that rug. And to be honest, you guys, I don't really recommend you guys purchase anything. I don't want to help you with your purchase decisions because I think you guys should make your own purchase decisions. But like, you definitely need to buy the City Living pack just for that rug. Like, that's the only purchase recommendation I'm ever gonna give you guys. But like, no joke, I love it. But anyways, we just went for this kind of matching dresser. It's also from Vintage Glamour, and I thought that that gray color, gray beige-ish color, really went well with the Moschino side tables, which was surprising because they're from a different pack, but the colors kind of match, which is like never happens. But yeah, besides that, we kind of just made this very minimalistic. Again, we went for that kind of gray neutral color scheme. So if you're not into neutrals and you're into colors, you might be on the wrong YouTube channel, but you also might be on the wrong build. I'm just joking, by the way. I do have some colorful builds in my repertoire, but this was definitely more of a neutral kind of earthy one. And you can see that I try and add a lot of plants here and there. And then somebody in the chat did also suggest to kind of take it a step further and put in a kind of plant wall using those little plant vines that usually belong on the exterior of homes, to put it kind of as a backsplash. So that might have taken it a little bit too far, but I personally really love it. And I think that it kind of gave this room a very whimsical and Pinteresty vibe, if you know what I mean. again, it kind of ties nicely with the fluffy rug that adds texture, and then there's just nice planty green texture up on the wall that's kind of subtle too, because the headboard kind of hides it. So I personally think that it goes pretty well. So now we are working on the kind of second container home. So they are technically two separate ones, but they're just connected by that little landing in the middle. So on the first one, obviously we had the bedroom and the bathroom. And then on this side of the container home, we are doing the kitchen, dining, living area. And obviously everything is very open concept just because it's too small to like section stuff off and whatnot. But for the kitchen here, I did go for a similar color scheme. I wanted to keep it very consistent, so very neutral, dark, whites, blacks, browns, very earthy. And I think that these base game counters actually go really well. It's not often that I use these counters just because they're such a specific style, but I feel like in this build, they definitely worked perfectly. And then I also just used some of those cool... Are they from Cool Kitchen Stuff? The cool cabinets that have like the glass, I really like them. They definitely add a really good modern touch. And what's funny is we didn't add a fridge for some reason. Like, I built this on stream for like 2.5 hours and nobody mentioned the fact that I forgot a fridge. People mentioned the fact that I forgot a garbage bin, but nobody noticed that we didn't put a fridge, which I think is so weird because people in my chat are so observant and see every little detail, but for some reason nobody noticed the fridge. Do you guys, people who are at the stream, you guys need to like take the fall with me for this one, because we all forgot the fridge, which I thought was hilarious. So I uploaded it to the gallery and then afterwards I was like, wait a second, there's no fridge. So I had to take it off and add a fridge, but I thought that was kind of funny. Also, we just did a really, really cool trick here that was suggested by Lil Rafty in my chat. We made a sectional couch. Did you see that? And usually the little part where the couch overlaps, it usually clips because it's like not supposed to do that. But Lil Rafty had the beautiful, amazing suggestion to cover that little glitchy part with these cushions from, I think it's my first pet stuff, I think. But brilliant. See how you can't even notice that it's clipping whatsoever? Now that I know this trick, like, the possibilities are endless to make sectional couches. So huge, huge claps for that. Give this video a thumbs up just for Lil Rafty, honestly, because that's like a total game changer and I'm totally using that for all of my future builds. So it's really cool that, yeah, I'm pretty sure that those pillows come with my first pet stuff, and then you can probably use this trick for like any couch realistically. So I was like mind blown when this happened, and I can't believe I didn't know about this trick until now. But yeah, thank you so much, Lil Rafty, for that suggestion. Yeah, you're the real MVP of this video. But here you can see we're basically just doing the little dining area. The spacing worked out nicely that we were able to have a separate kitchen, dining, and living space. And I think that having a sectional couch there really helps to kind of section off the the room. And then also the island placement there also helps to section off where the kitchen is. So that dining room placement just slots really nicely into there. And then the room was looking quite black and gray, and I knew that I needed to add in a little bit more plants and a little bit more greenery to add in some of that color that I wanted. So I ended up kind of mirroring the trick we did in the bedroom and brought in those vines into the wall, kind of like a feature wall. And it kind of sections off the dining room space pretty nicely as well. And then I, you know, popped in that city living rug underneath the dining table again, you know, just snuck it back in there. It's fine. We love that rug, you guys. But yeah, I do think that it looks really good with that green kind of backsplash there. It's not something that I would usually do in like a normal, you know, family home build, but because this build is a little bit more modern and a little bit more, you know, immersed in nature, it's eco-friendly, I thought that it definitely fit the vibe well. And overall, I think that this build turned out so nice, considering there's like literally no color in it. I think that it looks so sick. It's so chic and like I don't know. I love it. I hope that you guys love it too. And a lot of people on my stream, you know, had some really good ideas. So it's definitely like a combination of all of these great ideas into one build, which I think is great. But at last, we are doing kind of like the outside. I didn't want to make this outside part just like blank and empty. So we decided to put like a little hot tub and seating area just to make it a little bit more functional, have like some outdoor space. We always want a little bit of outdoor space just to make things a little bit more luxury and stuff like that. But anyways, you guys, the build is almost done. And guess what? Guess what? It is 2:18 a.m. in the morning, and this video is going up in like less than 6 hours. I've never done a voiceover this late in the morning or night, I don't really know. So maybe I sound a little crazy, maybe I sound a little wired, maybe I sound a little tired, I don't really know. But we did it, and we're fine. Everything is fine. I probably am not gonna remember anything I've said in this voiceover when I wake up tomorrow because I'm so tired, but it's fine. And I like this build, and I hope you guys do too. And I hope that you guys can tune in to the stream next time if you guys didn't get a chance to. Every time, it's just so much fun. So again, every Tuesday at 4:30 a.m. Pacific Standard Time. If you don't know what time that is in your country, if you live in a different time zone, then you should definitely like look it up and convert it. But yeah. I really hope to see you guys there, and again, join my Discord. But besides that, don't forget to rate my recreation out of 10. How close did we get it to the photo? And what do you guys think of the interior? Do you like what I did with it or not? But yeah, besides that, thank you guys so much for watching. These screenshots are definitely rolling right now. That was kind of a short video, but thank goodness, because it's so late and I need to go to bed and also upload this and also edit it. So yeah, thank you guys so much for watching. I really hope you guys did enjoy it. If you did, don't forget to give it a huge thumbs up and leave a comment down below what you thought about it. And if this is our first time meeting, don't forget to hit that subscribe button if you want to be friends or if you want to see more Sims 4 videos. I love you guys so much, and I will see you guys all in my next video. Bye, everybody.